We're waiting for Dr. Majken to appear. Let's see if she comes.
I just saw a man last week and he was just like, I've never heard of this condition ever. And it hit me, but what is it? What they see in these animal studies where they inject stem cells into the scar tissue is that it swifts us back to more normal looking tunical vagina. I've probably focused very much on Peyronie's disease the last 5 years. And it's more and more clear to me that we will probably have to do more than one thing to help these men. Mm-hmm. And also at a very much earlier stage mm-hmm. than we've done so far. So we have to communicate that it's important to come early and also, well, tell them about the different possibilities. Because even though there's no highly statistical significance, I think when you combine the different ones, I think there would be better results.
Yes, I think so too. Monotherapy is difficult. I think you have to combine several modalities. If a man comes to you in your polyclinic and complains of Peyronie's disease, what would you recommend all these measures combined? How would you start?
Oh, that's a good question. Because, I mean, men are different. So I try to find out what type of man he is. Because there's also some, for instance, the penile traction therapy is an option. There are good trials that shows that it's effective. Though on the other hand, it's time consuming. So some men with this time consuming activity every day for 3, 6, 12 months would make them even more sick. That's not the possibility. Other men would feel, I'm in control, I'm doing something, I'm actually taking action of this and would be empowered by it. So it depends on the man. But I tend to tell them about the different options. I also say that the only thing that we know that helps is operation. So they know that that's an option. And I tell about the side effects. And if they're not scared by that, I'll just say, it's a really good one. It's quite quick. And it has these and these side effects, and then we'll go that way. And then I won't tell them a lot about all the other stuffs because it is, you have to be motivated, whatever other thing you would choose.
Any medication that you would recommend?
Well, I've read a lot about the PDE5 inhibitors and the SERM, the selective estrogen now. And I think it's very interesting what they're doing in England, and they also published on human trials. But they also say that you have to be in the acute phase. I mean, and I just don't see them at that time. The other thing is, I am a bit reluctant to prescribe tamoxifen. It's just that it doesn't feel right until we really know if it's a good treatment because it has the side effects and it's for cancer. It's just like, I don't know. I haven't tried it.
Me neither. And it's not available, I think, at least in Germany. We have huge difficulties in getting certain medications, and tamoxifen is one of them.
Okay. Just now or?
For the last couple of years.
Okay. I don't know how it is in Denmark, actually. But I do, especially if the men say that they have problems with erectile dysfunction, I do give them PDE5 inhibitor. And I think there are a good studies saying that it can stop the disease, at least diminish the inflammation. And if they don't have any side effects, it's not that it's anything that will hurt them. So I do give them that.
Okay. So how many patients have you treated with stem cells?
Not that many, though, because it was just a small trial. But 22 was in my. We did a power before, and we needed to have at least 15. So we're happy with the 22.
And what are your? I understand that you haven't really have the data down, but your impression, the overall impression, does it help? Is it something that could be?
Yeah, well, my impression is that they fall into three groups. There's one group that's definitely had no effect whatsoever. One man was sitting in the chair, one follow up, and he said, you gave me placebo, right? No, there was no placebo in this trial. I was like, so he had no effect, and he didn't. I followed them up till 1 year, and he didn't get it. Then there is, in the other end, people who clearly had effect. I have one man that's just amazing. He went from 90 degrees to 45. I mean, that's just how. And he actually did it in the end of the study. So I have to look into why did he get such a great reduction.
That was monotherapy, no traction involved.
No traction, but penile manipulation.
Yeah.
They did on their own. Just like the ones we did when we had the collagenous Sciaflex or Sciaplex. It's the same I instructed them in. I said that they could do it for 3 months, but some has continued, and he continued up to a year. Which also makes me think that when you do it long enough with enough amount, you will get more results. Then the third group is the middle one, where they think they maybe have got an effect, but they're not sure. But they're happy that they did something. They're happy that they participated. They think the plaques got more softer. The wife is more happy. All those, that is not really a measure, but they are more content, they're more confident, and they have more accepted their disease.
I think the wives are very important.
The partners are very, yeah.
Like if we're talking about degrees, like if you have measured with a goniometer, it's so easy to miss 2 or 3 degrees and to measure and to come up with the same measurement every time. Like I would measure the same patient 3 or 4 times over, I would have different readings. And now if you read the articles and the publications and they come up with like 8 degrees evaluation, this is so small. And you wouldn't be able to see it by the naked eye. So I think the partners are very important, because if they say it's an improvement, then definitely it is. That's my impression.
Definitely. Oh, you're saying so many interesting things there. I had the exactly same thoughts. I'd like to return to that. But before I did, at the start of my PhD, I did a translation of the American PDQ, Peyronie's Disease Questionnaire, and I've used that one. And I think especially in the last section, which is the bother part, how much are you bothered by it? I think that's a very good measure of if there is. And I mean, even though there's not a decrease in curvature, but are they less bothered by it? That tells a lot. Or are in the first part that's about physical and psychological symptoms, are they also less, even though maybe the degrees is the same? And I think that tells a lot.
Mm.
Now back to the curvature measure, because I think that's a huge problem in the urological society. And I've really been thinking what to do. So of all the 22 men, we decided to do a side study of how to measure. So I actually just made the article and I've submitted it. I don't know if anyone wants to publish it, because I think this is hot stuff. Because once it comes out that we actually admit that calculating the curvature can have a degree difference of 5, 8, maybe 10 or 12 degrees, how can you say that a treatment of 8 degrees improvement is actually an improvement? So we looked at how, I mean, when you look at all the articles, they just said, we measured in a standardized way. Yeah, but how? I mean, no one says it. Back in 1981, a guy, a Turkish man, Kelami, tried to suggest a way to do it. No one uses the Kelami methods. When you Google or when you do the search in PubMed, there's no one. And there's been very good articles about we need to do the standardized, we need to agree on how we do, but we never agree. So we did all the measures. I had 4 experienced urologists who did the measures, first freehand and then with lines. There's not a huge difference. It's not that I hope that with the lines I could say now it's standardized, it's working every time. It didn't. Maybe I have to do it with even more men. I think 22 was too little, even though we had like 88 photos. But I've realized that it's important that it's the same person that makes all the measures. So for my stem cell study, I've had a colleague that's not an author, blinded to what photos are at the baseline, what photos are at 12 months. And she did all the measures. And I think that's the way to do it.
Yeah. That's a very important point.